So, guys, let's get to the texturing part, which is probably most exciting and will introduce a very distinctive look to our hero. The workflow for texturing our MetaHuman character that I'm about to show you involves Blender and Substance Painter. But you can of course use any other texturing software you prefer. As a first step, let's export the assets that we will need for texturing. What we need for that is obviously the body and head meshes. And since we don't want to start texturing from scratch, but rather build upon the already existing textures, we will also export the base color and normal map textures for head and body. So, let's do this first. Find your body mesh and export it as an FBX. Make sure to deselect every option in the export dialog. Especially, we don't want to export all the other LODs. For those who do not know what LODs are, LOD means level of detail. In game engines, it's all about performance, so every mesh typically has a number of lower resolution representations of the mesh, which are activated at increasing distance to the camera. If you export the LODs, you will get all those meshes in Blender. The head is even more complex and comes with 8 LODs. So sometimes people get confused when they see something like this. You can either delete all the meshes of LOD 1 and higher, or just make sure to untick the level of detail checkbox on export. Right, back to exporting. Export the body mesh and the head mesh, and then open the corresponding material instances. If you are having trouble finding the material instances, just click on your character folder and type synthesized in the search bar. Those are the two instances for the body and head, the body synthesized and the head synthesized baked materials. Find the base color and normal map of the body and export them. Same thing for the face, find the main base color map and normal map and export them as well. I will show you how we deal with the additional base color and wrinkle maps at the end of chapter 3. Now that this is done, we can open up Blender. The second step of the workflow is to really give our character some love and sculpt some nice details, as well as prepare the materials and textures so everything is neatly set up for a stress-free texturing experience. Let's import the FBX files in Blender and hide the skeletons. By the way, you can change the look of your mesh in the viewport in the Materials tab at the bottom under Viewport Display. As usual, I like to keep things organized, so I move everything into a new collection and call it Low Poly. This is going to be our low poly mesh, if you want, that we use in Substance Painter. Duplicate the collection and call it High Poly. Remember how I told you in Chapter 2 that we are not allowed to do anything to the mesh except moving vertices? The good news is, at this point we can do whatever we want to the mesh. Since we will not import the character itself back to Unreal Engine, but are only interested in the textures, we can sculpt all the details that we like and bake these details onto the normal map later. That means you can increase the resolution of your mesh to millions of polygons. You can use it in topo or remesher, anything goes at this point. Before we sculpt, let's join the body and head of the high poly model and then merge the border vertices. To select them, you can go to Select, Select All by Trade, Non-Manifold. We don't want to merge the eyelashes and mouth, so we go into X-ray mode and deselect those. Then just press M and merge by distance. Check if everything is actually merged by selecting the non-manifold vertices again. Cool. Now we can do a sculpting pass on our character and introduce some details. I will fast forward this part so I don't bore you with making you watch a long sculpting session. The only important thing here is the low poly and high poly mesh should more or less overlap for a clean baking result. So don't go too crazy here. It's only about details at this point. I I am now quite happy with my high poly sculpt, and we are almost done in Blender. We have already looked at the UVs in a previous chapter, but let's quickly refresh and also do some cleanup on the materials. I don't intend to change the texture for the teeth, tongue and eyes. The only thing I'm interested in is the head itself. If you go into edit mode and then to the material list of the head, you can select the part of the head that has the material head synthesized baked assigned to it. Then press P to separate this part. Back in object mode, we can now hide all the rest. Then, since all those other material slots are not needed anymore, you can click on the arrow and remove the unused slots. Now we have only one material for the head. As a reminder, the UVs for the head and body are located on different UV tiles. This is great since we can actually use a UDIM workflow for texturing across different UV tiles. If you don't already know, UDIM stands for Universal Dimension and is a way of splitting up the UVs of an object into multiple textures. This is used to achieve very high texture resolutions without the cost of loading huge 8K or 16K files. The UDIM tiles have a numbering convention starting with 1001, 1002, etc. for the first row, and 1011, 1012, etc. on the second row. Great, now we have almost everything we need to begin texturing. To use the UDIM workflow in Substance Painter, we need one single material for the whole body and appropriate texture file names. So let's join the head and body of our low poly model with Ctrl J and delete the head material. Now we can export our low poly mesh and the high poly mesh. Then, let's rename the textures. The UDIM textures need to have the same name, except for the UDIM tile number at the end. So we have the head UVs located on the 1001 file, and the body on the 1002 tile. Let's rename the base color and normal map accordingly. Now, open up Substance Painter, create a new project, select your mesh, set the document resolution, and activate the UDIM workflow. Then, let's bring our textures in. Select only the 1001 files and drop them in. Substance Painter will then automatically search for UDIMs with consecutive numbers and import them as well. You see here the number 2 displayed over the textures, which shows that the texture set uses two UDIM tiles, one for the head and one for the body. Let's check the UV layout, which looks good. And let's make sure we have only one material with our two UV tiles by clicking on the texture set list. Everything looks good. To get a base texture layer, create a new fill layer, deselect every other channel except for the base color and normal, and drop the textures into the slots here. Finally, we need to bake our hand-sculpted details onto the normal map. Substance Painter will also generate a couple of other textures that will be used in the texturing process, like the curvature and the ambient occlusion maps. Since we would like to stay consistent with the way the MetaHuman textures are set up, we will bake in 8K. And boom! We are done! Everything is set up, and it's time to give our character our custom look. Again, feel free to pause the course here and explore on your own. The next chapter is optional, but I will show you how I textured my hero in chapter 3.2 before going into how to use our custom textures in Unreal Engine.